If I were to talk to my 14-year-old self, this is what I would tell myself. Be true to yourself. Follow your dreams because you only have one life to live. Friends will come and go. Some memories will even fade. Every morning, you need to be able to wake up happy with yourself and the decisions you made.
Okay. There are a lot of things that I would say to my 14-year-old self, but I condensed it down to five. I'm going to call it the Harms High Five. I'm just kidding. I just made that up. You could edit that out. So my first one is not to be lazy and to give 100%. I was always pretty hardworking, but it was those times that I didn't give it 100% that I really regretted and wished that I would have. So don't be lazy. Give 100%. Learn from mistakes, not just your own mistakes, but learn from other people's mistakes as well. So you'll save yourself a lot of pain and suffering if you learn from those mistakes the first time. Be involved. You only get one high school experience. It's a one-shot deal. So you have to be involved in as many things as possible and try as many things as possible. And I did not say this to my own 14-year-old self, but I'm saying it to you. Put the phone down. Be involved. Put it down. Number four is to be tolerant, accepting, and patient. We are, you know, in high school, you're going to meet and make a lot of new friends, and you're going to meet people who are very different than you, and that is a great thing. So be tolerant of diversity, be accepting of those who are different than you, and above all, be patient with people. And last but not least, you are the only one that can change your attitude. You have full control over how you react to people. Life is going to happen to you, but you can have whatever attitude you want about those events in life that happen. And that's it. He was smart and made a pact with himself with a smirk and made a vow that one day his dad would never ever have to work. He plucked feathers from his back and watched his bottom limbs bend forward to a certain more. He wasn't sure. He plucked feathers from his back and watched his bottom limbs bend forward.
Commas. That hard work pay off, don't it? Plus it feel good when you can say you own it. No rent, lease, loan, or mortgage. That generator money, no he shortage. He plucked feathers from his back and watched his bottom limbs bend forward to a certain more. He wasn't sure. He plucked feathers from his back and watched his bottom limbs bend forward.
What would I say to myself at 14 years old? Well, how much time we have? First thing I would say to myself, listen to the grown-ups, because you don't know everything. You may think you know everything, but you don't. Second, I will listen to my parents. You know what? They know more than me. But at that time, I didn't want to listen. Third thing, I don't know how to drive. You may think you know how to drive, but you don't know how to drive at 14 years old. That's what I would tell myself. Fourth thing, all above. Go back to all above. But this is what I would say to myself at 14. Listen, keep an open mind, and just enjoy life. That's what I would say if I was 14 years old again.
My advice to my 14-year-old self would be to remember there's no whining in an honors class, slope is Y over X, and to always dress appropriately.
If I could go back and give myself advice at 14, it would be to remind myself often that I have value and I have a place. You might be picked on at some point. You may not feel like you fit in, but always remember that you have value, you have a purpose, you have a place in this life that is important.
Oh, in eighth grade, I was promising myself that I would grow, and I did. Believe it or not, this is my growing.
My advice to my 14-year-old self would be that the world is yours. It is what you make of it. There are a lot of opportunities out there, and that you should push yourself to accomplish anything because the world is yours.
Hello, graduates. We here at Cremonie Middle School are proud of each and every one of you. But more importantly, you should be proud of yourselves. Congratulations, happy summer to you all, and keep exploring the possibilities.
It might seem crazy what I'm about to say. Sunshine, she's here, you can take a break. I'm a hot air balloon that could go to space. With the air, like I don't care. By the way, because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel like a room without a roof. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel like happiness is the truth. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you know what happiness is to you. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel like that's what you want to do. Here come back. Bring me down, can't none.
hard, and I think you know what's coming. Never give up. Never.
Hi, everyone. Just remember, eighth graders, as you move on to the future, be the best you can be and always be true to your dreams and goals. Good luck in the future.
If I could go back in time and talk to my 14-year-old self, I think I would tell her not to be so hard on herself. I'd tell her to believe in the philosophy that you really can do anything you set your mind to. And when life doesn't give you exactly what you thought you wanted, it does give you a choice. And happiness is a choice, and I would tell her to choose it. And I think the final thing I would tell her is that whatever you decide to be, whomever you decide to be, make sure you're a good one. Be the best. And to the class of 2014 from Crete Moni Middle School, I would tell you that remember, you're perfect. You're perfectly you.
And I would do it for